Oh, hi guys. I'm Arime Versax. I am your teacher here, Mozax. So, welcome to Mozax Music Empire Channel. Today is another Tutorial Tuesday. Wow, I'm so excited. I'm going to learn new things today. As you can see, the board behind us is going to be serious. So you have to be very attentive today. Over to you, Mozax.
Alright guys, thank you for joining us today in our Tutorial Tuesday. We'll continue our class on saxophone. The first class, we talked about the saxophone syllabus, where I took you through everything you have to learn to be a professional saxophonist. That same class, in the first class, we taught you the care of your saxophone, saxophone family, parts of the saxophone. Then in our second class, we talked about saxophone embouchure, keys of the saxophone, and then basic fingering exercise. Those of you that missed those two classes, please check in the link, in the first two links below, and then you're going to watch. You can watch it and update yourself. But without wasting your time today, we want to go straight to talking about the keys, that means the saxophone fingering chart. How you are able to come out with several scales, and then you're able to stay in one key on the saxophone. So you have a lot of keys in the saxophone that we taught you last time. Now today we're going to tell you how to put those keys together and then form a melody, understand what we call staying on key and then staying on course. So today we'll talk about saxophone fingering chart, and then we'll tell you how to get the diatonic scale, the minor scale, the pentatonic scale of each keys of music. Okay, today I'll take you a little bit of theory, where first class I'm going to talk about I want to quickly talk about the keys of music. Keys of music. Music has what we call the major keys. Major keys, you have your key. You use your letter A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. That's your major keys. And then we'll talk about the accidental keys. Dental keys. In the accidental keys, you have your sharps, which I'm going to represent with this guy. And then you have your flats, which I will represent with this letter. Now, the sharp keys is just a sharp of the major keys. The flat is also a flat of the major keys. When we talk about sharp, it means you are going a semitone higher or forward. Then here we talk about you're going down, semitone backwards. Semitone backwards. Now, so when we talk about key A, you can have A sharp, you can have on the sharp, you can have A sharp, you can have C sharp, you can have D sharp, you can have F sharp, you can have G sharp. Then on the flat, you can have A flat, you can have B flat, you can have D flat, you can have E flat, and you can have G flat. So if you notice, there are some that don't, like you don't have B sharp. This is because distance between B and C and E and F is just a semitone. I'll teach you what you mean by the key intervals, note intervals, where we talk about the semitone, and the tone, talking about distance intervals between two notes of a scale. So that takes, so when we talk about A, B, and we're using this letter, and you see us using this raised to power hash or raised to power row, you will know that we're talking about flat or sharp. Flat means what? You're going backward. Sharp means you're going
forward.
Above or forward. So that is that for that. So I'll quickly talk about how these keys are arranged. When these keys are being arranged in keyboard, we start from letter C. So we have C. You have C. I hope you are seeing, I'm not blocking you. You have C. After that, you have C sharp. You have D. You have D sharp. You have E. You have F. Then you have F sharp. Then you have G. You have G sharp. You have A. You have A sharp. You have B. And then you come back to your C. So that's how it goes. We have C, C sharp, D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A, A sharp, B, and C. And then when we are going backward, you have C, D flat, D, E flat, E, F, G flat, G, A flat, A, B flat, B, and then your C. You must understand this order. If you mix this order or you don't get it straight, you are not going to understand how to understand the saxophone fingering chart. I can just show you the saxophone fingering chart, but without understanding this, you will not be able to bring it up. Because nobody have that time to start giving you saxophone keys on key C, saxophone keys on key D. So you are going to just have a chart, and then you are going to bring out you're going to from the chromatic scale of all notes of the saxophone, you're going to come out with all the keys of the saxophone where you're going to be playing per key. So because of this, so let me take you to what we call the scales. Scales, I'm going to talk about one, the chromatic scale. I hope you understand my handwriting. Chromatic scale. Chromatic scales we talk about everything is half interval, or what you call semitone. Half interval or semitone. All true. So let's start from your key C. So key C chromatic scale is C.
C sharp.
C sharp. D.
D sharp.
D sharp.
E.
F.
F sharp.
G. G sharp.
A.
A sharp.
B.
And C. So what if you are going back? Which one? So it will be C. This is like you have your C.
C
sharp. D. D sharp. But when you're coming back, it will be what? This guy now will now be what?
E flat.
So on. So this same guy is what? E flat. This is D flat. This is G flat. This is A flat. This is what?
B flat.
So don't confuse it. Then, in what we call the tonic sofa, the sofa notation, you call this your Do. This is your D. This is your Re. This is your Re. Mi, Fa, Fi, Sol, Zi, La, To, Ti, Do. So let's go again. Do, Di, Re, Ri, Mi, Fa, Fi, Sol, Zi, La, To, Ti, Do. Your C, you add your C sharp. Then your D, your E flat, your E, your F, your F sharp, your G sharp, your A, your B flat, your B, your C. That's about the chromatic scale. So after that, we talk about That's on PC. So let's talk about the major scale. Number two, your major scale. Major scale. Major scale is what we call, we can also call it the diatonic. Diatonic scale. This diatonic scale is where you have the keys, that the key we use is your home key, tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone. So you have your tone. If I am on key C, I'll go to my home key, which is key C. A tone means, what is a tone? Two semitones. We've told you that chromatic scale is made of all the intervals here is semitone, semitone. So if I say a tone, means a tone is this semitone half plus this semitone, which is half. So you simply jump one semitone to get to the other one. That will give you a tone. But if it's a semitone like we have here, you're just going to the next note of the chromatic scale. So you have your key C, which is your home key, the key you are actually trying to bring out this the major scale out of the chromatic scale. You have your key C, home key, a tone, you jump, you go to your tone. We have your D, another tone, you go to your E. Then semitone, you go to your F. Then a tone, you go to your G. Another tone, you go to your A. Another tone, you go to your B. And then semitone, you now have back your C. So your major scale of key C is C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. Which is in your solfa notation, you have this as your do, you have this as your re, this is your mi, this is your fa, this is your sol, this is your la, this is your ti, and this is your do. Where you have your do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. Brother, can you quickly let me blow it on key C?
Okay.
Oh, that's your C, re, that's your D, that's your E, mi, fa is your F, sol is your G, la is your A, ti is your B, and then do is your C. Alright, thank you very much. So that is your major scale of key C. How did we got that? Simply by arranging the chromatic scale, just go home key, tone, tone, semitone, tone, 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 semitone. That is that about that. So I will quickly take you to other keys of the major scale so that you can play as many keys as you want in the saxophone. Alright guys, so let's go back. You have your keys. We've done key C. Let's just pick another key and bring out the keys of that particular keys, both chromatic scale and the diatonic scale.
You can actually use that formula too.
You can use that formula to get any key of your own. Then just go to the fingering chart, bring out everything, copy it out, and then you are there for that key. So you can always learn all the keys of the saxophone on your own if you understand this principle. Okay, so let's pick key D, for example. So key D, let's talk about your key D, chromatic scale. Chromatic scale of key D, you start from your D, semitone higher, D sharp, semitone, E, semitone, F, semitone, F sharp, semitone, G, semitone, G sharp, semitone, A, semitone, A sharp, semitone, B, semitone, C, semitone, C sharp, and then semitone, D. You see, your chromatic scale of key D is what? D, D sharp, E, F, F sharp, G, G sharp, A sharp, B, C, C sharp, and D. That's your chromatic scale of your key D. Now, if I want to get the major scale of key D, of this same key D, we are on key D now. On key D, you have your home key, which is your D, a tone, which is your E, another tone, which is your F sharp, then semitone, which is your G, then a tone which is A, another tone which is B, another tone which is C sharp, and then semitone which is D. So the major scale of key D is what? D, E, F sharp, G, A, B, C sharp, and D, which is your Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do of what? Key. You see, the Western man is going to teach you music on key C, then they'll teach you on key D, then they'll teach you on keys, on all the keys, separate classes. But me, I'm going to teach you everything I teach you on key C, you can take it to all to other key, provided I teach you in solfa. That's why I prefer to teach in solfas, because in solfas, I can always tell you that the chord progression of this song is Do, La, Re, Sol. Now, if I tell you Do, La, Re, Sol, if you want to play it on key C, it becomes what? C, A, D, G. If you want to play it on this key D we just did, it's now your what? Your is now D. Where's your La? A. Where's your La? B. Where's your Re? Your Re is E. Where is your Sol? Your Sol is A. You see? So you already know the basic music that guide that song. But depending on the kind of key you are going to be playing it on, you will now use this knowledge to bring out the actual key you are pressing on the saxophone. So the music remain constant in your mind. You understand the music. All you need to go is to go to your saxophone and get the keys or whatever instrument you are going to be learning. I hope you understand why I'm going to be teaching you more on your solfa notation rather than teaching you particularly on the key and stressing the actual keys you are pressing. Because when you get to key D or key G, G sharp, it means you still need me to teach you those keys. But with this knowledge, you, and then with what I will teach you on solfa, you can as well just go and then transpose it into all the keys that you want to. I see, Professor, you will prefer that.
Yeah, yeah.
Me, I actually prefer that. Just teach me something I can now on my own
get other
keys. Means what if I have a guitar student? I taught this guitar student on key. I wanted to teach him on solfa. He said no. That every time he goes online, doesn't see solfa. That he only see them writing those chord progression on keys. So what happened was that he and I gave him the chord. For example, I gave him the chord as C A D G. But unfortunately, when they get to stay to play, the other guy, the person that was playing, now left the key. The singer that was supposed to sing now left that key. So everything now changed. So it was too late for him to understand. Okay, with this particular key I'm in, what the person actually knew was C A D G. He did not understand his Do, La, Re, Sol. If he actually understand that it's Do, La, Re, Sol, he would have said just, okay, this particular key that this lady just entered now is still Do, La, Re, Sol, I'm going to be playing. But in trying on with the understanding of this knowledge, he can now know, okay, what they call substitution in mathematics. He can now just substitute and understand, but that will take time to master. But we are going to take you that. So if you stay on this channel, you're going to really improve tremendously, and you wonder why. You mean this is so simple? Why has it been so? Somebody just came to me and said, "Sir, somebody has been teaching me saxophone for 6 months, and I said play something. I was still playing. No, I said, can you play other keys? I don't know other keys. I only know this." I said, wow. In 3 months, when I take that person through 3 months training, you cannot imagine the growth was unimaginable. So that is that for that. So that's on key D. You can try this out in all the other key. Can you just try key D for me? Key D major scale, which is she's on key D. That's key D. She's on key D. Re is your key E. Mi is your F sharp. Fa is your G. Sol is your A. La is your B. Ti is your C sharp. And Do is your D. Thank you, Verasax. So it means, can you imagine the same G that was Sol on key C is now your Fa on key G? You see, the solfa remained the same, but the keys are changing. That is what I'm saying. So if you always know the software is the key that you really need to really understand how does each key varies depending on the particular key you are playing. Okay, so that is that for key D. Let's talk about the saxophone sax fingering chart. It's a chart. Why do you call it a chart? Because everything is going to be together. You are the one that is going to bring out each what you want from that chart to get your key. That's why it's called a chart. So I'm going to draw a saxophone. Let's start from the lowest note of the saxophone. That's B flat. The lowest note you can get on the saxophone is B flat. So I give you B flat. B flat. So guys, you see, that's a representation of all the keys. So for B flat, you're going to be pressing this, and then you're going to be pressing this. That's your B flat. Like that, like that, like that. Others like that. Then there are other fingering chart. When you get to your C sharp, your D sharp, your F sharp, that's where you'll be pressing these other side keys, these ones, this guy. When you get to the octave of each key, you start pressing your this other side and this other side. So we're going to be teaching you practically from the next class how to get the keys of all, how to get the chromatic and the diatonic scale of all the keys of the saxophone. So you blow key C for me. That's your key C. Play key D for me. That's D. So you can just use this using the fingering chart that is showing on your screen. Then you use it. You can also just download it from Google and just type saxophone fingering chart. Just pick anyone you see there, and then using the knowledge I taught you now, bring out the particular key you are going to be playing, and then just know it. So in different classes, we're going to be asking you to play a key. Nobody's going to go back to see you how to get the keys of that. We expect that you understand this class. All right, guys. Thank you. I hope you've learned something today. We don't have time to show you all that. So in the next class, we're going to concentrate on key C now. And then we'll begin to teach you how to make melodies, how to do your scale permutation, and how to flow on the other fingering patterns that will help you master the saxophone. Thank you so much, Vera Sax. What do you have to say?
Thank you so much. Thank you, guys. See you in the next class. I'll make sure you rehearse the one that you have learned today. Bye.
No, before you say bye, I hope you know some of them have not subscribed to this channel.
Oh, if yes, that reminds me. Yes. Please. Subscribe to this channel.
Yes, because
you're going to learn a lot. Subscribe and press the notification bell.
By this side. You know why? Please. Because you'll be notified, you not miss any class.
And you need to comment. You need to say something that you don't understand.
Yes.
Say it out. air your view,
so that
we can just do something that will make us know that you're following this channel. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Bye. See you next time.
Bye.